And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday, November the 22nd, 2019. It was on this day in 1857, one of Britain's most famous intellectuals, a man admired for his rational thinking, a man who people would not have expected to write such a letter, Walter Bagehot, poured out his heart to his fiancée, Elizabeth Wilson, and wrote, "I wish I could feel worthy of your affection. My reason, if not my imagination, is getting to believe you when you whisper to me that I have it. But as somebody says in Miss Austen, I do not at all mind having what is too good for me. My delight is at times intense. You must not suppose, because I tell you of the wild burning pain which I have felt and at times still feel, that my love for you has ever been mere suffering. Even at the worst, there was a wild, delicious excitement which I would not have lost for the world. The time that I have known and loved you is immensely the happiest I have ever known." Walter Bagehot, who went on to edit The Economist magazine and extend its coverage to political issues and not only economic ones. It's the birthday of Picasso's great lover and his muse, Dora Maar, born in Tours, France, 1907. She was the model for Picasso's Weeping Woman portraits. She kept all of the art that Picasso had made for her, kept it in her apartment on the left bank of Paris, where she died in 1997 at the age of 89, a recluse without any heirs, and the work sold at auction for $30 million. It's the feast day of Saint Cecilia, the patron saint of musicians, who sang to God as she died a martyr's death. It was about 12:30 p.m. on this day in 1963 that President John F. Kennedy was shot and killed while riding in a motorcade in Dallas, Texas. Almost every American alive at the time remembers where he or she was when they heard the news. The Warren Commission published a report concluding that Lee Harvey Oswald acted alone in shooting the president, a conclusion that less than half of all Americans believe today. Don DeLillo wrote the novel Libra about the Kennedy assassination and wrote in an essay, "What has become unraveled since that afternoon in Dallas is the sense of a coherent reality most of us shared." And it's the birthday of the woman who wrote under the name George Eliot. She was born Marianne Evans in Warwickshire, England, 1819. Her first novel was Adam Bede, about a carpenter betrayed by his love. It was a great success in 1859. And in 1871 came her masterpiece Middlemarch, the story of Dorothea Brooke, an idealistic young woman who hopes to become a social reformer and marries a man only to realize that the marriage is a disaster and the man she really loves is her husband's younger cousin. Here's a poem by Thomas Lynch, Local Obits. It was the Alzheimer's made Maurice sweet those last 10 years, in contrast with the 6 decades and then some of huffing and puffing his way through 3 marriages, a couple of unsuccessful runs for public office, his business, and the love of his children. God's will is what his only daughter called it, to see that awful, angry man gone soft, gone simple, and benevolent at last. You take the good with the bad, she reckoned. He didn't know me at the end, but he approved. Local Obits by Thomas Lynch, from Still Life in Milford, published by W.W. Norton and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.